So good morning to all of you. Myself Priya Tiwari. I am assistant professor in faculty of pharmaceutical sciences, Rama University. So today I'm here to discuss about the topic of emulsion. So basically we are discussing about the, that is, what is the definition of emulsion, what are the advantages and disadvantages of emulsion. So starting with the introduction of emulsion. So emulsion are the two immiscible liquid form, as we know that. So there is the definition, that is, emulsion are the colloidal dispersion solution in which both the dispersed phase and medium are in liquid form. So here is the diagram that we can see that this is the beaker and in which two immiscible liquids, that means there is the dispersed phase which is form and globules form, and there is the dispersion medium. So in which the one liquid is dispersed uniformly distributed in the another liquid doses form. So we can see that the example of an emulsion, there is the milk. Milk is a natural example of an emulsion. So now we are moving to the advantages and disadvantages of an emulsion. So starting with the advantages. Number one is the advantage, that is, unpalatable drug can be administered in palatable form. Number second is the improve the rate of absorption. Number third is the some oil sensation drugs which are all soluble that can be masked in aqueous phase. So these are the advantages of an emulsion. So after discussing the advantages of emulsion, now we are moving to the disadvantages of emulsion. So the first disadvantage is that it required the proper storage condition, which is the main task for preparing the emulsion. Now the second disadvantage is that when we are using the emulsion, that it is more important to shake in every time prior to administration. That is the more difficulty situation in taking the emulsion. Now we are moving to the types of emulsion. So there is the types of emulsion. So emulsion basically divided into three main class. That first is simple emulsion. Number second is multiple emulsion. And number third is the micro emulsion. So starting with the simple emulsion. Simple emulsion has been divided into two major categories, that one is the oil in water emulsion, second is the water in oil emulsion. The globule size is approximately 5 micron. The range of the simple micro emulsion globule is the 5 micron. So there is the diagram. We can see that first is oil in water type of emulsion. So there is the diagram. In oil in water type of emulsion, the dispersed phase is oil, dispersed phase, and water is the dispersion medium. So this is the oil in water type of emulsion. Now we are moving to the water in oil type of emulsion. So just opposite of the oil in water, that means water is a dispersed phase and so water is the dispersed phase in boiling water type of emulsion, and oil is the dispersion medium. So this is the simple emulsion. Now we are moving to the second class, that is the multiple emulsion. In multiple emulsion, there is the three phases. So in water, in oil, in water type of emulsion, basically it has the delay the rate of administration, that means delay the release of the drug. So this is the main advantage of the multiple type of emulsion. Now we are moving to the third category, that is the micro emulsion. So basically micro emulsion are the clear homogeneous emulsion in which one insoluble liquid is dispersed in the second liquid. And the main advantage is the micro emulsion, that is the referred as solubilized system or transparent system. Why it's called solubilized system? Because it's having the globule size that is the below than 0.5 micrometer. So this is the main advantage of the microemulsion, that we are using the most microemulsion. Now we are moving to the emulsification. The second term is the emulsification. Emulsification is a simple process that form the stable emulsion. As we know that the emulsion are the unstable liquid doses form, because When two immiscible liquid are standing for some time, they are separate out. So they require the certain small amount of quantities that are added ingredients which form the stable type of emulsion. So that process is called the emulsification. Generally, example of the emulsifier, that is the gum, gelatin, and soap, etc. So these are the those agents which are adding in the preparation of emulsion to form the stable type of emulsion. This process is called the emulsification, and these examples are called the emulsifiers. Emulsifiers or emulgents. So this is the emulsification process, as we know that to form the stabilized emulsion by adding the emulsifier are known as the emulsification. Now we are moving the last topic, that is the test for identification of an emulsion. Test for identification. So number one is the dilution test. Number two is the conductivity test. Number three is the cobalt chloride filter paper test. Number four is the fluorescence test. So these are the tests which by which we identify that which type of emulsion we can use. So thank you.